high. If you are using Unity's HDRP water and don't know how to apply your custom mesh or create your own custom mesh for the water surface, stay with me until the end of this video. I will show you how to make one with ProBuilder. I'm using the latest Unity version, which is 6.11. Creating a single surface water component for your lake or river is much better for performance. In my game, I want to connect these areas you see with a custom shape using only one water surface. Download ProBuilder. ProBuilder is a tool that allows you to create and edit shapes without using external 3D software. Note that ProBuilder has changed in Unity 6, so if you are using an older version, it will be different. Go to Tools, ProBuilder, Editors, New Shapes. It's usually best to make your water just a plane, as other shapes can ruin the water's look, but it depends on your mesh. Drag and place the object. This object now has a mesh renderer with a ProBuilder shape. Change the size of the plane to cover all the connected areas. It doesn't have to be connected, just watch until the end of the video to see the goal. Adjust the height and width cuts, clicking the yellow button shows the cuts. I will set it to 10 cuts in height and width. The number of cuts depends on you. If it has fewer cuts, it would be easier to edit. For now, I will put it to 10 cuts in height and width. Press Shift and H to isolate your selected object. Before editing, first create the water surface by applying the water surface component. So this water is actually rendering infinity. Let's change it to custom and apply our mesh renderer. And this is what should look like after you put the mesh. So the problem is we have in here, there are some regions that we don't want to have this surface water. Also, I have this ocean water. Let me just disable it. Before editing, I will change my water surface settings to be my desired effect. Now let's go click on this yellow button. This button only appears when you select a ProBuilder mesh and then click on faces. So the mesh has vertices, edges and faces. I can just select a face and click on each face that is not in the region of the water and click on the backspace button or right click on the mesh and select the delete faces. Just be careful, we don't want to delete a face that is in the area of the water. And continue this process. Also, if you delete one face that makes an empty area like this one, you can just select the vertex and move it. But I want to avoid changing the vertex because sometimes it might be causing some water flickering, especially if you move it up and down. It will create an edge seams which is not looking good. So in return, I will subdivide the mesh, go to Tools, ProBuilder and Object, and subdivide the mesh. If needed, do a subdividing again. But don't do it too much, it will affect your performance. Now the only thing left is to remove the unnecessary part. So I face a problem in which a small part of my water is not covered. In this case, select all the edges and move them without going in the y-axis. And that's it, now you have your custom mesh for the water surface. To enable underwater effects, add a box collider and adjust its size. As you can see, under effect works fine, but there is a problem. You can only assign one box collider, and this box collider sometimes is out of the area we want, like here, and it shouldn't render the under effect, but it will. Posted this question in a Unity discussion, and a developer suggests detect when the camera is in an area without underwater effects and toggle it using a script. Use local volumetric fogs in subtractive mode to remove the underwater effect inside the caves. And yes, using multiple water surfaces will have a much bigger performance cost. Enough for this video, but in the next video I will fix the under effect issue following the Unity developer's advice. And also, I will make another video to show you how to export the train to Blender and make the custom mesh for water rendering there. If you'd like to see these two videos sooner, please leave a comment and request it. The last thing is we can go to Tools, ProBuilder and Export. And export OBJ or Assets format, which both will work. And the mesh will look like this. I hope it was helpful. I'm in the middle of a project. I won't say anything about it, I will wait until my project is more polished before talking about it. But anything I learned from making this game, I will share it with you, exactly like this video. It might be not the best solution, but it worked fine for me. Thanks for watching, see you next time.